another CG animated film, Casper's Dance School, which was released as direct to TV on Cartoon Network in 2006.
So
the film saw Casper enrolled in Scare School after making friends with humans instead of scaring them. While supposedly set in the same universe as the other movies, the character designs were much more cartoonish, and while still somewhat translucent, appeared more solid. Though Casper is seen with his stub tail in flight, here he could transform it into legs when standing. Despite the fact that Scare School featured the absolute worst, cheapest animation of the entire series, between 2009 and 2012, Classic Media produced a spin-off series of the same name for Cartoon Network, which featured Casper's continuing adventures in Scare School. Character designs remained largely the same, though animation quality was markedly better, improving even more so by the second season. Through a series of administrations, Classic Media was acquired by Boomerang Media in 2009 and then DreamWorks Animation in 2012, who renamed the company DreamWorks Classics. With NBC Universal acquiring DreamWorks Animation in 2016, Casper is now a wholly owned property of Universal. While Casper hasn't starred in any of his own series or movies since 2012, he did make an appearance in a 2019 Geico commercial in his 1995 movie design, and more recently in a 2020 episode of DreamWorks Netflix series Harvey Girls Forever, alongside various Harvey characters and even Spooky, who teach him how to be scary. In perhaps his most stylized design ever, Casper was given a more modernized, angular animation style, with a highly expressive face with large black eyes and a blue mouth and tongue, and was once again depicted with feet. Throughout the episode, he's seen morphing between both translucent and solid forms. While no Casper series or movies seem to be in the works currently, he does continue to appear regularly in comics. Most notable recent adaptations include Arden Entertainment's three-issue 2009 series, Casper and the Spectrals, which depicted him and other Harvey characters in a modern graphic novel art style, and American Mythology's reboot of classic 50s through 70s Casper's Ghostland, which saw him in yet another distinctive design that paid obvious homage to the mid to late 50s cartoons and comics. Casper's comics are currently distributed by American Mythology, who since 2017 have starred him in numerous series inspired by or reboots of classic Harvey comics. Casper the Friendly Ghost is a character unlike any we've discovered before in this series. He's one that has successfully translated through the decades in projects with varying degrees of success. And strangely, for a ghost, he has somehow avoided the cartoon purgatory that many of his contemporaries have succumbed to. Perhaps it's his ghostly nature, his pure innocence, his eternal search for a friend, or even his mediocrity that have saved him from becoming irrelevant or unrelatable. He's a character not really a product of his or any time, and it really is a wonder that he's remained so beloved for so long. But maybe that's his most charming quality of all. And at that, it's over to you. I want to know, what is your favourite Casper cartoon, film, comic, or overall appearance? Scare away down in the comments below and let me know your thoughts. Hey everyone, if you haven't yet, smash that big old subscribe button up on your screen to keep up to date with all my content, and hit that like button down below. Also, don't forget to check me out on social media, and please consider supporting me over on Patreon for as little as $1 a month for exclusive videos.
I don't remember, did you watch Casper when you were little?
On the screen. Thanks again for watching.
I don't remember that.
I remember seeing the commercials, but I never actually saw the movie.